Let's talk about the piece that probably OpenGov cares about. So the data portal. So the data portal is one of the projects I am incredibly proud of. When I inherited it in May of 2011, it was tiny. Like, I know there are people, how many people here remember the old data portal?
The fire logs, you mean?
Yeah, that one. So, okay. So, not much to it. And one of the 100-day goals, like, I don't know how many of you remember, the mayor had set a list of goals for the first 100 days. And I remember the Sunday before the administration started, the whole policy group sat down, and we went through the list, because the mayor said they'd be done 100 days, and none of us are going to say no. One of the things was to ramp up the portal. Part of that was apps for Metro Chicago. And this is one of the things where really a cultural change turned things around quite a bit. Many of you know Danielle Dumaire, right? Danielle's our buddy, yeah. She's not here tonight. She's driving back from St. Louis. So she had had the task of the data portal for some time, and it was a tiny project. When the mayor came in and I got engaged, this went into high gear, and we could spend a couple hours talking about all the things we've done in this space. But here's the lesson. I remember the first couple months I came to one of these meetings, we had a dialogue, we talked about committing to making Chicago out in front in this. And over the past 2 years, the Open Data Portal has gone from what it started to being arguably probably the most robust in the country, if not internationally. It's something we're incredibly proud of. And there have been these just amazing milestones. In the first year, the crime data. So I came in and I said, we need to release our crime data, and not just the historical 90 days, which is what had been done before. I want to release all crime data from January 1, 2001 to present. I wanted to have an ETL that fired every night and refresh that data. And I wanted it to be instant level data. Now, that's craziness. It's being commandeered. Do what you will. So when you think about what's going on in other governments, like, what do they typically do? It goes to the precinct level. It goes to the district level. There isn't that level of transparency. There isn't that level of data. And, honestly, it was a big lift. One, quality of data, dealing with that. Like, Joe and I don't even know how many phone calls we had trying to figure that out. But also getting over people's fear. It's people, like, there were many discussions in which people would be afraid of releasing data. And one of the ones was all of the crime data. And then one day we did it. And I think it was originally, 4.7 million rows. And the benefits behind this are huge. One is a transparency piece. This is your data, okay? So it is out there. It is machine readable. But on top of that, so originally the idea behind it was transparency, and then so many other things came from there. And a lot of these things I had no clue. One of them was a research site. Had a bit of a clue on that. But I started to get calls from researchers throughout the country saying, you have just changed everything because you released all this data. I've been trying to get a data set like that for years, and now it's out there, and it updates every day. And from the social science folks, they were just, this changes the whole game. My favorite, and I've talked about this publicly before, was a tweet I got with the crime data, which is, the girl, and I forget what school she was at, which said, "I am finally able to finish my PhD dissertation. Thank you." And that's great. So we have transparency, then we have research, we have the whole sort of community outreach piece, and then we have this interesting thing we're trying to get our mind around from open data, this idea of economic development. And this, I think we're still figuring this out, so I shouldn't be talking about early in the presentation, I guess future things. What is the role of open data in economic development? I had a discussion with Alex Howard when he was still at O'Reilly to get at this, because how do you quantify that? Like, we have these anecdotes of companies like Spot Hero that came out of apps for Metro Chicago, and now they're getting venture capital funding. Like, that's crazy, and that's good. But how do we continue to foster this? How do we, like, I believe, like, Tim O'Reilly used the phrase government as a platform. I absolutely believe in the data portal as a platform. I think most people know I don't want to be in the app business. Like, I don't want to build unitaskers and things like that because I worry that government can't sustain it. What I do want to build is this robust platform, this robust portal that is available via API, and you can count on it to be fresh and provide you folks, to provide the community, to provide people with a way of accessing. So I think this is something that we didn't, when in May of 2011, at least I didn't see that piece. I saw the transparency piece, and it's proven to be so much more. And going from the idea of crime, which was a big release, to now things like traffic, which we refresh what, every 10 minutes or something?
Current traffic every 10 minutes is historical traffic.
Yeah. So we are now actually, that's becoming interesting. That's a relatively fast ETL, and that's all available. Data.cityofchicago.org has become the standard for data portals out there. Like, we get countless calls saying, "Oh my God, how did you do it in Chicago?" We're now I've been working with Jen Palka from Code for America. We're putting together a series of chapters on open data, and Chicago's one of those stories. Like, this is what's happened in 2 years, and this is, like, this is what folks here have been asking for, and we've sort of done that. And we've gone in the past 2 years from it being sort of the novel thing to part of standard business. So the data portal went from Danielle to Tom a number of months ago because we stuck in the data group. Data portal in the data group, that's fine. And Tom now has one of his staff members whose job is to curate this, to hear what people want and to make it happen. It is now part of standard Department of Innovation Technology business. That's how far it's come in 2 years. The other piece to mention is this data dictionary piece. And this is something that we've been working on for a number of months now. People, I think, know that MacArthur gave us a grant, it's been a year ago, to help document our data. Now, for the majority of people that I talk to, this is a mundane thing. Like, "Oh, great, he wants to talk about documenting data. Okay, Brett, that's great." But there's vision here, because what is data without understanding the metadata, right? And MacArthur's made this investment to help us, like, what did we all inherit? We inherited a bunch of old transactional systems that have all of these fields that have names that I don't even know how they came up with them. And it's a big enigma. And what we've been doing for the past months, for the past year, is putting together this data dictionary. And that is part of the sustainability, and that is part of the forward vision here, where each step along the way, we're going to understand our assets, we're going to document it, and then we're going to release it. Most of you know that Mayor Emanuel issued an executive order in the end of 2012, which mandated open data. Okay, it was actually really handy, because in the executive order, he created a chief data officer. And considering I'd been doing that for a while, it actually, I felt I had some job security, so it was really good. But at the same time, it created an open data coordinator in every department. So Tom did the kickoff meeting last month in which each department sent someone, and they now talk about what data they can release. There's an annual report, and you know I'm not a big fan of reports, but whatever, which says what we've done and what we plan to do. It's now an executive order in the city of Chicago. Like, this is worth, pause for a second and think about this. This is Chicago, which in 2 years has set the example for open data transparency. It's codified via executive order. There's dedicated staff to it. And the majority of this, so I like to joke that people are surprised when I say, when data goes onto the web, there isn't a little dude in the basement of City Hall vetting it. It's blocks of Java that update the portal so that I can go away, Tom can go away, Jonathan can go away, Danielle can be gone, and the system sustains. It's actually harder to turn it off at this point than it is to keep it on. That is how I architected this, because it's part of standard practice. And that is sort of Chicago setting the new leading.